It is minus 3 Celsius, extremely overcast and extraordinarily icy outside. I ain't going outside. Everything's covered in a layer of ice, so yeah. Ice bad. If I fall, I get hurt. It's that simple. And if I fall, I need to go to the hospital, even if I'm not that badly hurt, because I might have a brain bleed because I'm on blood thinners. And it's a total pain in the ass. So, you know. It's only 8:30 in the morning and I'm about completely done with this day. I really am. I've had enough already. I really am. I'm just completely frustrated, completely ticked off. Power keeps going out. Every 20 minutes to half an hour, boom, no power. So, I've been up since 4 o'clock in the morning. Power has gone out a bunch of times, so no laundry for me. You know, I was getting laundry ready. Poof, no power. So power comes on. I'm make myself my morning coffee. I'm enjoying my morning coffee. I'm doing something on the computer. Poof, no power. And of course it kills my save file, which means it's corrupted. And I have to delete the save file. And I'm just doing the jigsaw puzzle. Every time you put a piece in, it saves it, right? Well, I had to start over again, you know, because, you know, we couldn't finish a puzzle before the, a single puzzle before the power goes out. Yep. Oh, God. And a few months ago, I'd reinstalled Windows on my computer because it was messing up pretty good. And you do that and it cleans everything up and it runs faster again than all this and doesn't clunk out on you. Anywho, I had forgotten to adjust the power settings, the advanced power settings, so that it won't reboot after power outage. And sure enough, it's rebooting after the power outage. I'm like, I don't want that. You know, just do not want that ever. Why do you do this as a default? Oh my God, it's just so annoying. Yeah. What else? Yeah, I guess I'm not doing the laundry today because it's going to be busy in there by now. There's going to be people using the laundry by now because, you know, everyone else is up now. And it's going to be people in there all day. There always is. There's no end to the amount of people in there all the time because, you know, most people do a tiny little bit of laundry every couple of days for some reason. So they don't let it build up for a while and do a whole load or anything like that. No, we just got to put three things in the washer. I've seen it so many times. Why are you watching only three things, you know? You have to own more than that, you know. Anywho, and of course, there's only one good dryer, only one. And the rest of them take like literally 2 hours to dry my stuff. Itchy nose again, of course. It's been itchy for days, and it's driving me absolutely insane, I tell you. Not just when I'm on camera this time. It's been just nonstop for 2 days. Anywho, yeah, only one good dryer. The other two take literally 2 hours to dry my stuff. Damn it. And I just don't want to take 2 hours of my freaking life right now to dry my laundry. I just don't. I'm not going to. I'm not going to sit there for 3 hours total, you know, an hour to do the wash and then 2 hours to dry it. I'm just not going to sit there for 3 hours. 2 hours is my bloody limit for sitting in the laundry room. It's just that simple. And I am not coming back up to my apartment to be nice and comfortable because my shit will go missing. I've had trouble with that in the past, and I've seen I've heard other people having trouble in the past with their shit going missing, so it's just not happening. It's just not. I gotta sit there and babysit my laundry, so you know. At least I got my coffee in. Yeah, I pulled the video asking for the $15, even though I didn't get it. I'm not going to get it, obviously. So, yibbers, yibbers, no money for me. Won't be able to pay the card off all the way, but it's kind of sort of okay, even though I'd really like to have that 10 extra dollars that I won't be able to put on the card. I'd really like to have that extra $10 on there, but I'm just going to be short as hell next month on money. I mean, really short. So I got a few expenses coming up that are very much not usual, and it's going to be a pile of money, and I can't afford literally anything next month. So it would have been nice to be able to pay that off. So I guess I asked for 20. I don't know, but yeah, 25 would be the optimum. Then I would have coffee money for the rest of the month as well. Then I wouldn't have to put on my credit card. That would be the optimum, but not gonna happen. So yeah, it's not a need, so people ain't gonna do it. So yibbers, yibbers. A little bit of haze in the air I see as well. Ice fog, maybe? I don't know. Whatever. Just barely. Did my budget for the month. I'm gonna be spending $125 on groceries. That's the bare minimum I can get away with. So, you know, that does include a single luxury item on payday, or on the day I order the groceries. If that's payday, I don't know. It might not be. It's not a big luxury item either. You know, it's not like $20 worth of something. You know, it's like $7 worth of something. It's a thing of macaroni salad that I like, a macaroni and cheese salad that I like. It's really good. It's got little bits of pepper in it and little bits of celery and stuff like that. And it's just completely yummy. And I literally can't reproduce it at home, so for the price, I would probably spend $25 on the components. So it's just, you know, not it's not in the budget to try and cook it myself. I've come to the conclusion the days of me being able to cook stuff at home that's instead of getting prepackaged is over, because the prepackaged is almost always cheaper now than doing it myself. So it wasn't at one time. You could easily cook something for half the price of the prepackaged, but now that the food prices have gone way the up, and I mean way the fuck up, I've doubled the amount that I pay on groceries a month in the last year, literally doubled. So, you know, and that doesn't include having to get a couple of things during the month, because I just didn't know that I was gonna need them, you know. I always have a tiny bit of money set aside for that. But this month that ain't gonna happen, because I'm gonna be broke very quickly. I'll just have coffee money at best for the rest of the month after about the 10th. So, yep, I'm screwed. I'm screwed, but that's life. April is extra money month, thank God. I'll be able to have a little bit of fun in my life for a change. Sure as heck not going to that dinner theater. That's for damn sure. I'm not going to have no $60. That's for sure. $60 plus tax. That's what, $66? Yeah, $66 after tax. I don't know. There's 11% tax anyways, whatever that comes out to. I can't do math anymore. I've lost the ability. So, 666 or whatever, you know, I don't know, whatever. Or 6666, yeah, I think it's 6666 actually. So, because 11 would be 666. I think, yeah. Anywho, I don't care. Whatever. Yeah. Life is one frustration after the other this last couple of decades. Actually, the last 3 years have been rather hellish on me, and it's this year it's turning out to be the same. It's going to be rather hellish yet again. So, health problems, all to yin yang, all kinds of other problems, money issues. Never going to get out of debt. I was planning on trying to get out of debt by the hell on the recycling truck. Bang, 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 bang. The garbage one was here at 6 o'clock in the damn morning. Bang, 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 bang. 6 o'clock in the morning. Anywho, yep, so yeah, it's, I'm not going to be having a lot of fun this year at all. Bang. Yippers. Yeah. Not going to be getting out of the debt. There's no possibility of me getting out of the debt. I can't. There's no possibility. I'm never going to. So, once you're in it for life, basically. Oh well. Just the way it goes. I'll never have enough money to set aside to pay off the debt. So it's just that simple. Can't happen, not unless I win the lottery, and I can't do that because I don't play the lottery. It's a waste of money. I'll never win. Only people that don't need it win. I've almost never seen somebody who deserves the money to win. It's always somebody who's going to die in 2 more years, or somebody who's got a lot of money anyways, you know? Yippers, I make $120,000 a year, but I won the lottery. Yay! Yippers. It's never some poor people that, you know, could use the money to get out of poverty. Never. So, I guess once in my entire life I've seen that happen, but and that's it, basically. I don't know about other countries, but here, that's all I'm ever aware of is the one time. The one guy I remember won the lot. Won, what was it, $2.4 million, and he blew it in 6 months. That's phenomenal to me. Even I couldn't do that, you know. And then he won again. Again, the next year he won another one point something million, and he blew that in a short amount of time as well. And then he topped himself because he was, I guess he realized how futile it all was. And I don't know why people do that. No matter how my life is, I still want to live. So, yippers. Anyways, Anywho, that's it. That's all. You have a fabulous day. Keep smiling, eh?